Hey everyone, the key to getting your morning energy, daytime energy, and nighttime sleep dialed in is really to control your cortisol levels. People hear that, they think, oh goodness, now I just have to get into stress control, have to start meditating a lot, etc. Listen, if you can meditate, great. Known benefits of meditating. However, when I say getting your cortisol right, what I mean is you want high levels of cortisol, yes, high, upon waking and in the first hours after waking. You do that with viewing bright light, ideally sunlight, hydration, exercise will help. There are a bunch of other things that you can do that I talk about in the new episode of the Huberman Lab podcast. Guess what? I didn't say caffeine, because caffeine, if you are a habitual caffeine user, you drink caffeine daily or three times a week, you won't get much of a cortisol increase from caffeine, nor will you get much of a cortisol increase from deliberate cold exposure like ice baths and cold showers if you do it two times a week or more. If you don't drink caffeine and you don't do deliberate cold exposure regularly, then indeed you'll get a big increase in cortisol. Most people don't realize that. Caffeine will extend the duration over which cortisol is active, but it's not going to increase your cortisol much if you're a regular caffeine user, as I am. This information is also useful for understanding how to control your cortisol in the late afternoon and evening. Here's the thing. Yes, you can drink caffeine in the afternoon or evening and still fall asleep because it doesn't increase your cortisol much. However, it will disrupt certain aspects of your sleep. Should you exercise in the evening? Well, if you can't exercise in the morning, yes, definitely exercise in the evening. Exercise in the evening of moderate to high intensity will greatly increase your baseline cortisol levels because your cortisol levels are very low in the evening, or they should be. So if you exercise in the evening, you're going to need to do a few things to bring your cortisol levels down very low so that you can get deep sleep at the start of your night. And I explain how to do that in the Huberman Lab podcast. Yes, it involves keeping lights dim, etc., but there's some other tools as well. And I also talk about the use of things like licorice root, believe it or not. The glycyrrhizin in licorice root, not the candy, but in licorice root, is a very potent way to increase cortisol. I've been experimenting with this a little bit in the early part of the day, and it's a remarkable effect, so much so that licorice root is contraindicated with certain medications. So take that into account if you have Cushing's or something like that. If you don't, licorice root is a potent tool to elevate your morning cortisol, but you want to approach it with caution. And then there are things like grapefruit that, believe it or not, are very potent at inhibiting the enzymes that break down cortisol. So there are a lot of tools in the episode that I discuss. I mentioned a few here. If you have questions about cortisol, put them in the comment section below this post. You can find the episode by going to hubermanlab.com. It's timestamped, so you can navigate quickly to all the things that are most of interest to you. And as always, thank you for your interest in science.